I'm still young, but I know how I feel. I might not have too much experience, but I know when love is real. By the way my heart starts pounding when I look into your eyes, I might look a little silly standing here on the stretch.
Kids. Everyone look right here. 1, 2, 3. Say happy anniversary!
Happy anniversary!
Good job! Yeah.
Deeper than the ocean, and higher than the pines. Cause girl, you do something to me. Down in my heart, I know I look a little crazy.
Over here, 1, 2.
Standing
three.
With my arms stretched all apart.
Big cheesy smile.
I love you this big.
Good job, okay.
Eyes have never seen this big. No one's ever dreamed this big.
So, anyways, we would like you guys, after 59 long years, to redo your vows in front of everybody that loves you.
So 59 years ago, they got married just with a couple of witnesses. It seems like the family has grown just a tad. I wonder how that happens. Nonetheless, so 59 years ago in Moorhead, Minnesota, so in 1954, right, you two got married, and since the last thing you want to do is to hear a preacher go on and on, I'm going to get right to the point today. Now, at some point, you decided, did he propose?
Oh, many times.
Many times. So at some point he wore you down and you said yes, right? Well, this, for all of the kids, grandkids, and great grandkids here, aren't you glad?
Yes.
Yes, yeah. Absolutely.
We had 3 kids and they all had 3 kids.
Well, we're fairly sure we know what causes that today. Modern science has informed us of a great many things. Nonetheless, the scriptures teach us that wherever two or more are gathered together in the Lord's name, there he is in the midst of them. So you can be assured that the Lord is with you in this day of celebration today, right here, looking forward to having some cake right along with the rest of you. But I'm going to get down here so everybody can see you. I'm going to ask you a couple of questions, all right? John, will you have Phyllis to be your lawfully wedded wife from this day forward? To love her and honor her and keep her in sickness and in health? If so, answer, I will. Phyllis, will you have John to be your husband for all the trouble that he will no doubt cause you? For all the pain and sorrow, and yet love and cherish him throughout time? If so, answer, I will. If you have to, yes. Now, all right, John, you're going to go first. I'll give you these lines, you just repeat after me, okay? Like any good husband. You just do what you're told, right?
Yeah.
I take you, Phyllis, to be my wife from this day forward, to join with you and share everything to come. And I promise to be faithful to you until death parts us. Wonderful. Now, Phyllis, would you repeat after me? I take you, John.
I take you, John.
To be my husband.
Be my husband.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
To join with you.
To join with you.
And share everything to come.
And share everything
to come. Very good. All right. And I promise to be faithful to you.
I promise to be faithful to you.
Until death parts us. Let us pray. Almighty God, you have seen these two people through all the ups and downs of married life, and you've blessed them with children and extended families of great beauty and grace. We give you thanks that you have blessed them over the years, and we pray that those blessings continue, that all the days they have together may be filled with more happiness than tears. We ask this in the name of Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen. Well, John and Phyllis, by your promises before God and in the presence of this family and grouping of friends, you have found yourselves together yet again as husband and wife. Blessed be the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Those whom God has joined together, let no one put asunder. You may kiss the groom. And you have another 59 years of wedded bliss. And if you have that party, we'll all show up, right?
Yeah.
Very good. Congratulations.
If I send a rose to you for every time you made me blue, you have a room full of roses. Do you wanna cry? And I know that my soul is until